interesting morning up ahead, and of course some performances as well, which will start off right now with a number from Diwa De Leon entitled Japanese Garden. With a performance called Japanese Garden from Diwa De Leon. And syempre ngayon naman, chichikahin na naman natin po siya. So I have with me Diwa. Hey Diwa, thank you very, very much for taking time out to actually be with us this morning. Diwa, first things first, me and Monica were intrigued with your instrument. Two strings, this is what you call hegalong.
Yes.
Saan siya galing?
This is a native instrument from Southern Philippines. This particular one is from the Tiboli ethnic group.
Okay.
But I did some modifications myself.
How do you discover these things? Like with your instruments, and most of them are Filipino.
Yes.
Very, very proudly Filipino in nature.
Yes. Very Filipino. Actually, my discovery of this started when back in high school at the Philippine High School for the Arts, because part of our curriculum was to study indigenous music.
And sana may ganyan pa rin hanggang ngayon, no?
I think so.
I can only hope so, because the only thing Well, I won't mention my high school na. Pero parang natatanan ko lang sa amin pag mga linggo ng wika lang eh. Diba?
Medyo. Siguro. Pero there are some schools that are really pushing an indigenous music program. So, meron pa rin naman ng ano. Meron pa rin namang nangyayari.
Well, that's fabulous because you really took it seriously and you made it into a career.
Yes.
And in fact, besides the instruments, you name your band also, Makiling,
yes.
Proudly Filipino.
Yes.
And I want to lead this one to your recent trip to China.
Oh,
you performed at the Nanning?
Yeah, at the Nanning International Folk Music Festival. It's an annual music and dance and mostly arts festival organized by the Chinese government. And they invite several countries. This year, there were 19 countries. And we were the ones representing the Philippines. My
fabulous
band, Makiling and I.
Ano yung mga numbers na pinatugtog mo doon?
We performed our original music, but it's the music of Makiling is really based on a traditional Philippine music. So, medyo ano pa rin eh. Bumagay pa rin talaga sa festival.
But the thing is, you want to be very, very true to the essence, to the nature of your kind of music. So, pupunta kang, yun nga, sa Tiboli.
Mm-hmm.
Pupunta ka rin sa Mindanao maybe? Or, I mean, do you bond with these tribes, with the groups?
Well, some artists believe that bonding can help. Bonding with the artists can help. But I myself, ang kailangan ko lang talaga is the music. So,
marinig mo lang.
Luckily, my father one part of his career is recording the actual music from the field.
Talk about talagang pushing it to the next level with the next generation.
So with these recordings, I just listened to them and took what I needed and then started from there.
And it needs a keen ear. Kailangan magaling yung pandinig mo dahil to others, especially pag sanay na sa mainstream, parang pare-parehong toing, 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 toing. Diba parang it's either a pull of a string, a whistle, you know, blowing a wind pipe, a wind instrument of some sorts. They think pare-pareho, but if you listen closely, iba yung beat nito, iba yung pitch or what, there's different, and the way it blends together, right?
Well, it's yung not usual human principle na if you're not familiar with something, parang pare-pareho lang para sa
iyo. Exactly, but no.
Because we're so familiar with mainstream music, we already differentiate it on the right of the bat. But with the ethnic music, which is not really that common yet, medyo tunog pare-pareho for the common ear. But if you listen carefully, you can discern it eventually.
Well, hopefully with the Hegalong project that you're actually spearheading, yes, sana, especially the kids nowadays, will get to fine-tune their hearing, their discernment of music. Tell me about the Hegalong project. Obviously, it's named after your instrument.
Yes. The Hegalong project, is aside from my band, the Hegalong project is my solo effort. And I'm focusing on the promoting the Hegalong, but with a more electronic and modern version type.
So there's
going to
be like an electronic Hegalong.
Well,
someday.
This one is already an electronic Hegalong. If you see this, this is ripped off from an electric guitar.
And then you put it in the wooden instrument.
Yeah, so it's easier to perform live.
And if you didn't notice how we started the show kanina, my iPod, my little nano ka pa.
Yes.
So for people who keep thinking it's modern days na kasi and all that, modern technology and music and traditional music obviously mix fabulously.
Of course.
And speaking of traditional music or musicians, you have had the distinct honor of actually performing with people like Grace Nono, Joey Ayala,
yes,
Cookie Chua, just to name a few. Kamusta yung mga collaborations na ganun?
It's pag mga collaborations with these really known artists, it's really an exhilarating experience.
Diba?
It's really parang talagang nakakadala because they're already there and I'm for once in their life I became part of it, parang ganun.
And this is one of the things that we really need to strengthen again. Hindi pwedeng mawala to.
Yes,
kultura natin to.
Oo.
So for people who think na the shelved na yan, no,
it's
you will
not.
I think the torch has been passed on to you now.
Maybe.
Don't you think?
But
have to continue.
I think so, but there are also actually a handful of groups like Makiling and there are around 10 groups who are also promoting ethnic music, so I'm not alone.
Yon. Paano ka pa, how ano kaya mga tips na mabibigay natin sa mga kabataan para sila din sumali sa bandwagon na to? It's already one step. Na again, it's been mandated every hour for OPM songs. And this is part of OPM.
Yes.
Diba? Should be played in the radio.
Yes.
Just to, again, for the kids nowadays to be familiar na this is Filipino music.
Well, actually, everything starts with a little research. And of course, everyone is a bit curious about their roots in some part of their life. And it's really good to research about something about your culture. So you can start reading books. Even the internet has already a lot of information about Philippine music. So start with a little research and start from there.
And not just necessarily research, but to find the instruments. I think if you hold it, because with me, I have to admit, one of the things that I really got interested in, speaking of Filipino instruments, I love yung maliliit na gongs.
Yeah.
And also the rondalla, diba? Yung mga shake. I love that. And what's the one, the 16 strings? Yung more than 6, no, 12 strings or 9 strings?
Sa Filipino, Banduria.
Banduria ba yun? Filipino din yan, diba?
Yeah, Filipino, but influenced by Spain, but
mostly Spanish.
But it's been adapted by the Filipinos.
Exactly. So parang if you get to hold them, there is this natural curiosity that will hopefully drive you forward. And that just means you don't necessarily have to just take trips. Hindi lang hanggang museo.
Yes, of
Kailangan
course.
Manood ng mga performances tulad, no? Nang sayo. Where can we catch you, by the way?
Well, my gig schedule can be seen at my website,
okay.
diwadeleon.com.
All right. And speaking of Diwa de Leon, maybe someday we can find you in your band back here on Chica. Maybe. But right now, Diwa, I think you owe us another number.
Yes.
So go ahead, play the Hegalong, and thank you very, very much
thank
for being
you
with us
much.
This morning. Take it away, Diwa. Thank you.